Audience participation is something that I'd like to talk to you about here. It's really important to draw your audience in. You're talking about live theatre, and there are some important things that you can do to draw your audience in. One of the important things you do to draw your audience in is get your puppet to talk to the audience.
Hey, hi guys. Hey, what's going down? How you feeling today? Are you enjoying yourself?
Well, I think they're enjoying themselves, Scraggly. It's always fun to learn puppetry, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Hey, you guys look awesome today.
They do look awesome today, don't they, Scraggly?
Yeah. Especially that one sitting over there.
What about that one sitting over... Oh, I see.
Yeah. He looks really funny.
You think so?
Yeah. That's a funny color shirt you got on.
So picking out things like that about them is important. Also, picking out things about their personality.
What a funny laugh you have! That's weird!
Don't be rude, Scraggly.
Oh, sorry.
The beauty of a puppet is that the puppet can be as rude as it likes to the audience, and of course the puppeteer can correct it all the time.
Ah, well sometimes you've been rude and I've corrected you.
Yep, that's another way to do it too. The argument that goes on between puppet and puppeteer can sometimes draw the audience in. You can, first of all, tell them that something is wrong when really it's right.
Ah, or right when it's wrong.
That's right, yeah. The puppeteer can get confused, or the puppet can get confused, and then you can turn to the audience and ask them what they think.
Ah, let's see now. 2 and 2 is 6, isn't it?
Is that right? Is 2 and 2 6?
It isn't? Well, what's 2 and 2 then?
Well, let's see if we've got any mathematicians out here, shall we? Let's see. Any mathematicians? Oh, there you go. You over there. How about you telling us what 2 and 2 is?
4? Oh, I thought it was 6.
I don't know where you got 6 from, but maybe it's because you've got so many arms and legs that you can't count properly.
Oh, yeah. That might be the reason.
So draw the audience in by asking their opinion about something, and of course moral issues are really important there too. Is this right? Is this wrong?
Is it right that you should have your hands stuffed up by No,
Scraggly, that's quite enough, thank you.
Oh, is that rude, is it?
Yeah, well, that's a moral issue too, being right and wrong and rude.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to be rude.
Another way, of course, is having an argument with the audience.
Well, what are we going to argue about?
Anything. You can argue about anything, of course.
I'm going to creep up on Angelica and give her a thright.
You wouldn't do that, would you, Scraggly?
Yes, I would.
Do you think he should do that? No, that's right, he shouldn't.
Yes, I will.
No, you won't.
Yes, I will.
No, you won't.
Yes, I will.
No, you. And you can coax the audience along with this, you see. If you're saying it like this, then the kids are going to be responding in the same way. So the yes, I will, no, I won't. Any of these things will get the audience participating, joining along with you. And that's the beauty of puppetry, especially with ventriloquism, is it's live entertainment. And the audience has a feeling that they're participating in the direction that this play's going. So they're kind of directing it. They're kind of a part of what's going on. It's not like they're just looking at a TV screen and sitting there dumbfounded like you guys are right now.
They are?
Well, look at them.
Whoa, they are, aren't they?
Yeah, they should be participating, shouldn't they?
Ha ha, different to live theater, isn't it?
It is different to live theater. But when you're actually sitting there in an audience and you're starting to get participation going, it really is a special magic and a special thing happens there.
Oh, well, what else do we have to tell them?